custody of the regime's morality police. It happened after she was arrested for not wearing the required hijab or head covering. Amna Nawaz is here with more.
In videos being shared on social media, women are seen leading the protests in Iran, taking off their headscarves, chanting slogans, and calling for an end to compulsory hijab. Is this a turning point for the women's movement there? To discuss this, I'm being joined now by Iranian-born actor Nazanin Boniadi, an Amnesty International ambassador and a longtime human rights activist for her homeland of Iran. Nazanin, welcome to the NewsHour, and thank you for joining us. After the death of that 22-year-old woman, who we should know is named Mahsa Amini, we have seen these protests spread from her homeland, her home province of Kurdistan, all the way across the country, dozens of cities now. Is what we're seeing unfolding now, is it different from previous protests we've seen, for example, back in 2019? What do you see?
What I see is history repeating itself. We've seen the death of Neda Agha Sultan, we've seen Puya Bakhtiari, we've seen Navid Afghari. The list goes on, and I think people have just reached their boiling point. A brave Iranian actress from inside Iran, Khatoun Riahi, recently gave an interview where she didn't wear the hijab in solidarity with Mahsa and this movement. And she said it best. She said, people are no longer fearful of prison because Iran has become a prison itself.
And Nazanin, you were born in Tehran just after the revolution. Your family then fled, but you have been a persistent and a vocal critic of the regime from outside the nation. You stay in touch with many people on the ground, though. What are they telling you about this moment?
You know, I get hundreds of messages from inside Iran every day, and all they're asking for is solidarity. They're asking for their voices to be amplified. As a longtime human rights activist, as you said, that's the only responsibility I have. As an actress, I feel obligated to the people. I feel responsible to them. They are the ones, the people, put us in these positions where we have a microphone in our hand and we can communicate to the masses. The least we can do is stand with them. And I think in this moment in history, we need to remember that when George Floyd was, you know, killed by police in America, there was global solidarity. You saw images from inside Iran, inside Syria, places where they themselves are in dire straits, showing solidarity. The least we can do in the West is to show solidarity to the people inside Iran.
Let me ask you about this enforcement of compulsory hijab inside Iran, because officials there defend it. They say it is part of Iranian culture. You and many others in the diaspora have taken to social media to dispel that. You've been sharing pictures of your own families before the revolution, before 1979. One of your grandmother, your aunt, your mother were seeing there, your mom working in 1975, your parents' wedding. What is important to understand about the role of hijab in Iran and Iranian culture?
I think before 1979, when women had the freedom to choose, you saw a coexistence of women who chose to wear the hijab and women who didn't wear the hijab coexisting peacefully together. There was a freedom of choice, and that's what we're fighting for. I think to call it a cultural dress code of kinds, which the former foreign minister Zarif and countless other Iranian officials have tried to sort of tell the wide world, the global public, that's a myth, that's a lie, because what kind of cultural norm has to be controlled through batons and through threat of death and imprisonment? You don't need to subjugate people for a cultural norm to exist if the majority of women actually chose the hijab. But what you're seeing is people risking their lives. You're seeing people taking to the streets and risking imprisonment. And in Mahsa's case, her head was bludgeoned against a wall, and she went into a coma and died.
Nazanin, also Iranian President Raisi is going to speak before the United Nations General Assembly in New York this week. What do you hope other world leaders' message to him will be?
A lot of Iranians will be there, Amna, to protest his presence. A lot of prominent Iranians and Iranians in general. And what we are hoping is that Western officials, you know, especially women and journalists, when they meet with Raisi in New York, that they don't follow these protocols and these parameters that are being set for them. simply in solidarity with the people of Iran. You know, you don't need to wear a headscarf out of respect for a man who doesn't respect the rights of his people or women in general.
Nazanin, you are currently starring in Amazon's Lord of the Rings TV series, and when it launched, you said that you were dedicating your work, you were inspired by the brave women in Iran, who you said risk everything for a better tomorrow. How worried are you that they will now face another brutal crackdown as they have in the past?
I'm extremely worried, but, you know, when people have nothing left to lose, they will risk everything. They have nothing else to risk. So I think that's what we're seeing, is when authoritative states crack down to this degree where people feel completely hopeless and they have nothing left to lose, they will stand up, they will rise.
That is Nazanin Boniadi, an actor and human rights activist, joining us tonight. Nazanin, thank you for your time.